We got a glimpse of what Illustrator for iPad is going to be like at Adobe Max, and I have to admit, for me, it was the highlight of the whole show. I am super excited to tell you that I got invited to test the beta version of the app and to share my unbiased thoughts about it with you. I was asked not to show the user interface as it is still suspect to change, but that will only help to focus even more on these 5 cool features that I'm going to share with you in this video. When you're drawing with the pencil in Illustrator for iPad, you can pause to create corner points. So this can help to separate your curves. So even when you're drawing with a single line, like you can see here in this example, I can separate the continuous flow of my curves and create those corner points. So this is brilliant because I can very quickly create cool line work, combining curves and straight lines. But of course, when I'm ready, I can also edit every detail. So I just have to switch to the edit mode and I can remove anchor points that I don't need. I can refine the ones that I have. And it's just very similar to the desktop experience, but I would say it's much easier by using touch gestures and also the Apple Pencil. And by the way, there is a smoothness option with which you can adjust the automatic refinement of your lines. Drawing in Symmetry is a pain in the desktop version of Illustrator, but luckily on the iPad, it's so much easier because there is a dedicated Symmetry feature. So you can just start drawing with the pen tool or pencil tool in this mode and everything will automatically be mirrored on the other side. So the cool thing about this is that everything will be still editable. So even if you stop working in Symmetry mode, the whole object that you're working on, so all these lines will be combined into this special group or symmetry group, I guess we can call it, which whenever you go back into making changes to the group or even adding additional lines, it will still remember your symmetry, the center of symmetry, and also going to continue mirror everything. And it's worth mentioning that you can also expand this special group, so that will make both sides editable independently of each other. Working with clipping masks is also really cool in Illustrator for iPad, because instead of having to create the masks on top of the objects that you would like to include in the mask, here it's the reverse. So if you have a couple of objects already, like in this case, in this illustration, you can see the inside of the ear, for example, or the eyebrow, the shapes were already there. And for me to be able to add these additional lines inside those shapes, all I had to do is to draw over them and then select all and turn into a clipping mask. It makes so much more sense. So it's literally just the reverse of the behavior from the desktop version of Illustrator. We have great news for you if you cannot wait until the app's official release. Adobe provided our viewers an early access sign up. Just follow the link in the description below and sign up now to get an opportunity to be invited to participate in the beta program when more seats become available. There are 2 types of repeat options in Illustrator for iPad, the pattern and the radial repeat. Here you can see I added a couple of triangles on the top and I turned them into a group and I'm using the radial repeat option. It's amazing because you can very quickly increase the amount of elements. So you can always adjust that later. You can adjust the center point and also, of course, the position and the size of your repeat. Apart from this, you can also adjust the sweep, with which you can create a gap in the pattern. And it would actually look quite cool in this composition just to have it on the top, but I decided to have it all around just so you can see how the feature works. And once again, this is fully editable, just like everything else you do in this app. It is also very intuitive to work with text. You can even drag and drop text onto an object to create type on path. So you can adjust and move the text inside or outside of the path, and then later on you can change the shape easily with the text still intact and inside. The text of course is also editable at any point, and you can even adjust it further within or outside the shape. So these were my five favorite features of the current beta version of Illustrator for iPad, and I can't wait to try out all the other features that are planned for the release. Thanks a lot for watching. Like and share this video if you enjoyed it. Don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell icon to get notified whenever we release new videos. Click on the link on my right and start your membership today to get access to over 200 hours of training courses and personal mentoring by me and my team of creative professionals. Have fun learning, guys, and I will see you in the next one.